when I was growing up, my grandma was living with Alzheimer's. My mom's oldest sister developed the disease. She's living with it in later stages today. And then my mom was the next one in line. And so, of course, we're all very scared that she's the next one who will get it. And so I'm really interested in, you know, using this window I have to try to, if she does get it, improve the quality of care that we can provide. At SafelyYou, what we do is we put a camera in the private room for folks in memory care that choose to have it. But we do something special with it, which is that we write artificial intelligence algorithms which can detect from that video feed if somebody's on the ground. And it also means that we can be deleting everything else at the point of recording, so that only if a fall video is detected do we send that out. People say, well, you're just detecting the fall. How do you actually prevent falls? One of the big misconceptions is that a fall is a very dramatic incident that is going to result in an injury every time. That's really not the case. What you have is folks who are falling a lot, and they're falling over and over, and each time there's a 10 to 15% chance that they have a hip fracture or something like this. So the sooner we can find out that they're falling, figure out how they're falling, and put protection in place, the better our chances of preventing them from needing to go to the emergency room.
Before, I was getting calls because she would sit down, but they have to call the EMTs to check her out if the nurse wasn't there. And then the falls were happening at night, and we couldn't figure out why they were happening. And I know the staff did everything they could to try to find out what was going on, but you can't have 24-hour watch.
We have a resident who was having falls unwitnessed in her room, and we didn't know why. So after the SafelyYou cameras were installed, we were able to review the falls that she had and try to figure out why. They were simple things like rolling off her bed and hitting the floor. So we were able to say, okay, let's rearrange her room a little bit. Let's move her bed this way. And honestly, since we've done just those few minor changes, I don't believe she's had a fall since then. It was nice to be able to see that, fix it, and the family members were just like, yes, because we feel hopeless when we can't help them and we don't know what happened.
I think I've grown closer to some of the staff because they'll tell me, you know, what she's been doing, and if she does slip, I get a phone call that says, well, we found your mom, but she's fine. And now I get, she hasn't fallen out of the bed.
We want to enable folks to enjoy every moment still and be able to live in each moment, but have that invisible safety net in place so that we can have the right protections for them.